You're just a decent fish, huh? Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King Lure Company, number one in fishing lures. Ardent, rule the water. Go on there. Look at her pump. Look at the little smallmouth bass.
Oh, look at her.
Look at him go, eh? Look at him go, eh? Whoa, doggy. Oh, one for the net. Thanks, Jay. Right on.
Oh, hey? Boy, look at that.
Let's see the penetration.
That is close.
Look at that. Wow. Here we are, late November. After snowstorms, catching smallmouth bass, and it's that extreme, and everybody fishes for muskie and pike, and you name it, and it's just something different about coming out when no one else is out there, and it's cold, and it's fall, but the fish are still biting. We're almost ready to put the boats away, but look at this. It's a beautiful morning. Barely got him in the nose right here.
In the bottom.
Oh, right through, eh? Wow. Need your pliers? Nope. You know what? I should, like I always say, I'm going to put a few in the box. Because I don't like to let them go right where we're catching them. And, you know, maybe they spooked the other ones. I don't know. But there's no harm putting them in the live well and letting them go. So it's bucktail day with my buddy Jay. And we're going to catch them right here on grass and weed in late November. Stick around because it's going to be a blast. Let's go.
It's a good start.
Yeah. Getting that first fish in the boat, it's just a feeling. You know why? This time of year, it's all about, you know, timing, when they're going to be biting hard. But you come out too late and it's just like they're gone. They stop biting. They're in deeper stuff. But right now we're on a grass hump. There's different grass humps out here, shoals, rock, and we're going to keep fishing. We're going to keep throwing the good old bucktail, one of the oldest baits known to mankind. But this baby catches everything that swims. Seriously, every fish that sees that will eat it. There's different ways to fish it. Today we're throwing it with a violent rip, cause that little reaction that they come over and look at it. And when it's falling, boom, they usually eat it. We lift up, the fish is there. But again, timing, getting out, perfect morning. Let's hope we get some good ones. Let's go. It's so important to keep your focus on watching that bucktail go down. We're finding that the fish are like right off the bottom and stuff. So you gotta watch that line. It creates that slack, not too much slack, and then just give it a shot. Go down, let it settle, give it a shot. Pick up the slack. It's repetition over and over and over again. But that's the beauty of, you know, ripping bucktails. In late fall, early winter, you can cover water and find those fish that want to eat. Just moving and ripping. Dang!
Water?
Yep. Like a twin of the other one, Jay. Trying to splash. Might be able to lift this one. Or, look at him going to the boat. What does he think it is? Summertime? Boy, they're still scrappy, huh? In the boat. Thank you, sir. Oh, they cold. Wow. Like, I mean footballs. Look at it. Look what that penetration is. Auto let off. You know what happened, fish gone. But, and they are like tough. This time of year, their bodies are just like solid, like steel. Look how curled up he is. See? Like a football. Again, I'm going to put them in there. Let them go. We move around. Look at that belly.
They're on the feed.
Big time, eh? Just tough little fish. I love you, little smallmouth. We're looking for those big cousins. But I can tell you honestly, boy, this time of year, when I'm thinking about doing some Christmas shopping, and I'm out still catching bass, not just on a drop shot or maybe a different presentation, it's a bit slower, but I can fish the way I like, fast, powerful. Keep going, let's get some more. You know, this type of year, when you're throwing the bucktail like that, cast after cast after cast, repetition, fatigue is a killer, seriously, because your mindset goes, your focus goes, you miss those subtle bites. And for me, the right rod, there's different sizes, different actions and stuff, but for me, medium action, 6'3", 6'8", with a 2000 Ardent 20 pound gamma braid. It's called Torque, and it's just perfect. 20 pound, but very thin. Feel those subtle bites, but I can rip through that weed with a little bit of effort, but I still have that backbone to pull those bigger fish out of the weed. So again, 6'3", medium action rod, and it's just like an extension of my hand. Soft, sensitive, strong. It helps me pull those fish in the boat, and I don't get worn out. Rip, let it drop, weight, bottom, rip. It's all about repetition, baby. It's all about repetition. What is it, Jay?
It's not very big. Largemouth.
Largey. Smorgasbord, Jay. Jay gets a bucket.
Just a little guy. But he ate it.
Ate it good, eh? Yeah, oh, wow, look
right
at that.
Down. Little fish.
November bass.
Nice and clean.
Still fun to catch, huh?
There he goes.
Was he there on the lift or on the rip?
Just on the rip.
Yeah? You know, people think smallmouth are so smart. Oh, they see the braid. The water's clear. They're not going to eat it. Are you kidding? This time of year, it's about, you know, it's a responsive bite. They're looking at it, it's just reflex. Huh? What is it? Time to eat? You see the stomach on these fish. They see that thing, we're triggering them to see it when it's ripping, and when it's falling, sitting on the bottom, they just come over. Very opportunistic smallmouth. They see something, it stays in their face long enough, they're gonna eat it, or they're gonna try to eat it. That's all we're looking for. The braid just helps with that thin line going through that weed. We can pull through and not get frustrated and have no weeds on our hook. So it's just reel in, cast out, rip, and catch. There we go.
Got her.
Yeah.
What do you got?
Ooh, smallmouth. Trying to run. Smallmouth bass in fall. Looks like a little fatty too, Jay.
Oh yeah. Oh, that's a good one.
There's a fat one.
That's Ooh. A good fall fish.
Boy, he ate it nice. Look at that. Look at that hook
where
is.
You want it.
That's those bites you like, buddy. Beautiful. Live well.
Yeah.
Beautiful bite. Just that knock. Wow.
Thick fish.
Yeah, man. Awesome. Moving around a little bit. Traditional spot sometimes. You got to move to find them. When you keep moving, you keep finding them. I put them in a box. Smallmouth bass. One of you. Jay got a largemouth. Missed a few bites. I missed a few bites. You know what? Seriously, we could have had by now, I don't know, 7 fish. We got 4 in the boat. And it's just a matter of process elimination. Like I said, find weeds, edges. Go close to our shore. You think the fish are all offshore now, you know, winterizing and stuff. Or doing their winter thing. Not happening yet. They're still bait close. They're still feeding. We're still catching them. Go get a big one. And as for cast length, we're not making long bomb casts. We're dissecting those little clumps and edges, breaks, whatever you want to call it, right in front of the boat. Almost a boat length and a half up front, 25, 30 feet. Covering that water, those edges and stuff that are right in front of you. Now this time of year, those fish don't care. They're right down where they want to be, where they're feeding, on those clumps, the edge of the clumps, a break, sometimes there's gravel, whatever it is. They're just in that deeper stuff. So you want to cover that stuff that you see in front of you, and you have a lot better control with wind, especially when using braid. You make those long casts, you got too much bow in the line. Unless those fish are really suicidal, you won't feel the bite. And today, it's been lift up and the fish is there. The closer, the better. Got him? Atta boy. Size? Oh, yeah. Let me grab that net, Jay. Fight him out. Fight him out, buddy. Atta boy. Where are you? See? Atta boy. Nice one. Look at that fat smallmouth bass. Good one, buddy. Look at that. It's look at the belly. Hey.
Almost a clone to the last one.
Yeah, man.
Right where you want it. Nice chunky fall fish.
I love how they look, don't they? Look tough, don't they?
Oh yeah.
Little warriors. Let's
even
box them.
Even in November, they pull.
Yeah.
You know, this one thinks it's what, July? Yeah, jumping like that? Yeah. That a girl. Beautiful. All day long.
Love it. Something about that braid too, eh?
Yeah.
Just the lip, instant.
Rip, boom. And 90% of the time they're stuck.
Yeah, a lot of fun. Let's keep going. Get some more, buddy.
Alrighty.
Every time you catch a fish, it's imperative. You check a few things. Your knot, the knot placement on the bucktail, sometimes it slides around. You gotta make sure it's right at the very front there. It doesn't go, you know, where the hook eye meets the bend. Because sometimes that braid's so thin, you set hook, and if that braid, that knot isn't at the top of the hook eye, it's on a little bend there, potentially you can come out because there's so much force. You're setting, there's no stretch, so something's got to happen. And if there's a little weak link in the chain, you're going to find out because you're going to lose the fish. But I always check my hook points, check the barbs, you name it, because you know you're hitting your zebra mussels, a lot of weed stems and things like that. Anything that can potentially, you know, take off that edge off that hook point, that's when you lose fish. You check it, make sure it's nice and sharp. Gonna put those fish in the boat.
Cottage Angler, tips and tactics to make you a better fisherman.
Hey there, Extreme Angler TV. Mark Menendez here with the last saving grace for topwater. Hey, topwater bites in the late fall, right before the water starts to harden up in your all's part of the world. How about a buzzbait bite? There's nothing better than a buzzbait bite. Even though in the summertime when we're retrieving this bait at a fast rate of speed, they smash this thing, they crash, it's a lot of fun. But you want to catch a truly big bass? There's something about big bass and topwater in late season fishing that go hand in hand. This is a Strike King Tour Grade buzzbait, and it looks a little different than the average buzzbait. I've done some modification to it. Nothing that you can't do. First and foremost, take the blade, bend it up, stretch it out a little bit. Now you see that I've got a different angle. It's not straight anymore. It comes down at a right angle. You can see that helps slow the bait down. I've added a space monkey to the back of it. Big soft plastic bait, lots of appendages on it, and it has this flat back for one specific reason. Slowing down the buzzbait. Using big line, 20, 25 pound line, not for the strength of the fish, for a big diameter to slow that bait down while in the water column. You can see I've got my rod tip up and that buzzbait's barely on top, plop, 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 plop. Keeping my rod tip up using a very slow gear ratioed reel and big line helps slow this presentation down. It's a big presentation. I want a bulky presentation. I want a dark presentation. A great target for these slow, lethargic, cold bass. Make multiple casts to a target, a log, weed bed, big rock. Keep it on top of the water, just barely plopping along. This will be a slow motion animated strike. You'll see the fish come, he'll ease up, he'll nip the bait, he'll come down, and he'll have your buzzbait in his mouth. A buzzbait, right before the ice comes in, hey, buzzbait, topwater, fun, equals big bass. For Extreme Angler TV.
couple ways when I'm ripping like this. You know, you think it's just go along and throw out and hold the rod like this and flip and just keep hitting and ripping it, you're gonna catch fish. But when you're doing this all day long, seriously, it's not a matter of doing it for 10 minutes, 50 minutes on a spot. It's repetition. Instead of holding the rod like this, traditionally, these handles are made on the Legend Extreme. Awesome. I can hold it up like this, flip the handle, rip, and my whole hand is gripped around the rod like that. A lot less fatigue for going all day long. And that's a big thing when you're making thousands of casts and rips all day long. A little bit higher, you still got the grip. All this is all balanced. Fatigue, just burn you out. For this kind of fishing, you know, I'll be honest, you don't get a lot of bites. So you gotta maximize those bites. In any soft bite, it just goes from the braid right up into the reel, into the rod, and I feel those bites. Lean back and set. Fun way to fish. You can cover water, find those fish that want to bite. Good one too.
That's a good bend.
Yeah.
Dogging? Is that a bite? No.
Oh, big smallmouth, boy. Wow. Oh, that's a hoss.
Look at the belly.
Yeah. Look at him shaking his head.
Yeah.
That's a hoss, Jay. And hoss. Hoss caught that. Right. Where'd they get him? Oh, right in the nose. He didn't like that. You shouldn't have bit that bucktail. Look at that. That's my Christmas color, eh? Nice rosy red and black. Merry Christmas, smallmouth. Another one for the box, Jay. Almost on our waypoint, huh? Look at that football.
That's a good fish.
Wow.
Look at the tail.
Yeah. It's so important, man. The sensitive stuff. Good rod, good braid. It's just terminal tackle, easy. Jig, line, rod, reel. Real simple stuff. That's the result. In mid-November, let's put her in the box. I love it when a plan comes together. You know what? We had a wicked snowstorm this week. Boat had like this much snow in the cover. We thought maybe had to go one more time before the boat goes for the long winter sleep. But working back and forth, two rods, ripping, dropping. And the key I'm finding, you know what, we're fishing between 9 to 12. A lot of those fish, you know, you start thinking where they were close to the bottom. You got to throw it out, let it go down, let the line settle. When it settles on the bottom, then rip. And I've only felt maybe two bites that way, but it seems like they're going and picking it up when it's on the bottom. This kind of fishing, the sonar, is a must. It's not a maybe or, you know, having one that's subpar. It's so important to find those edges. We're catching fish in 8 and 9 feet, move out to 10, 11, 12, subtle. You know, you just look and you think, well, how much deeper is it over there, over there? That little change got some bigger fish. A good sonar, split screen, you see your waypoints, you see your trails, you just see that subtle edge drop where the weed starts, begins, and ends. That's where those bigger fish have been. And it's so important to have that sonar on the front, linked up with the console. When you're driving, you can see the waypoints. When you get up on the front, you're right where you want to be, where the fish are. Where's those big, fat smallmouth? Looking for another largemouth, Jay?
They might be in here.
Big, fat, largey. Atta boy. Feel good? That's a man. How's it feel? Smallmouth?
Is it a green one? No, brown one. No, it is green. Oh, that's a good one.
Nice
fat.
One. Oh, yeah. Get some close
with oh, it. Yeah.
Oh, nice one, Jay. Deeper stuff, huh?
Yeah.
Attaboy.
I love my green fish, that's for sure. Not a giant, but good solid.
He's variety. Yeah, man. Put him in a box. Maybe I'll let one of those smaller smallmouth go, you think?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do the mixed bag thing.
Yeah, man. How's your hands get nice and
that's
cold?
That's a good one to let go, I think.
Sure. Yeah.
Just beautiful. Like that. Working on a pretty good limit, my man.
Yeah, man. Where's that big fat smallmouth?
There's the walleye.
It's big.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Big, big?
Yeah.
Oh, double header.
I think I just won. If he's in the front.
I got another green.
Oh,
one.
God. Look at this thing, Jay.
Swing him right up here.
Look at this.
What do you got there?
Big smallmouth. Real big smallmouth. Real big smallmouth.
I'll just let this guy go right away.
Okay. Look at him. Let's see it. Look at that. Wow. Holy moly.
That's a thick, thick fish.
Hey. How much is he even eating, huh?
Oh, my.
Wow. Well, that's what you get in the fall when you rip and go. We're ripping and soon we're going, but you just dissect where they are, get on top of the fish, don't move around a lot, and you're gonna catch them just like that in November, anywhere else you fish. Listen, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler TV when it's a little bit warmer with shorts and sandals, catching smallmouth like this. Thanks for watching.
Daiichi, world's sharpest hooks. Snagproof, a leader in weedless frogs. Gamma fishing lines. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.